Namaste everyone, and we are going to start our today's session. First of all, myself, Hina Sharma, I'm connected to Swasti Yoga Center since 3.5 years, and I'm a level 2 certified yoga instructor. And Swasti Yoga Center welcomes you all for Global Yoga Festival. So let me first introduce what all we are going to do in Global Yoga Festivals, what all activities are there. So we are celebrating 75 years of India's independence and launching a year-long celebration from August 2021 to commemorate 75 years of independence with a slew of programs for global audience encouraging yoga for health and wellness. Now, we have more than 8 categories, 50 plus topics are there, 75 programs or workshops are there, 50 plus speakers are there, 30 plus countries would be there. There are different activities we are going to conduct, like panel discussions, quiz and essay contest, bhajan, kirtan, chanting would be there, how to go for sattvic Indian cooking, life guiding sessions by our speakers, question answer rounds would be there, and experts are going to discuss about Ayurveda Dincharya. Now, let me introduce our today's speaker. Our today's speaker is Shruti Kulkarni ji. Regarding her qualification, she has done her MPH from Boston, from USA, and she went to Tilak Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya, Pune, and Kaivalya Dham Lonavala. She has completed her level 2 teacher training certification course from Swasti Yoga Center itself. So I welcome Shruti ji, and you can start your session. Thank you.
I want to share my screen because I want to share the PPT that I have made. So
can yes,
I?
you can start sharing, and please you can start the session with the prayer.
Can everyone see my screen now?
Yes, it's visible.
Yeah. Okay. So I'll start my PPT. Okay, so today's topic is yoga prospects and challenges in USA. So let me introduce myself. I'm Shruti, and I have completed my MPH from Boston. I also completed a course of Ayurveda from Tilak Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya, and I was affiliated with Swasti when I was back in India. I completed my level 2 certification, and I thank Dr. Vikas Chute and Shweta ma'am because they gave me this opportunity to speak on this platform. I think this is a big opportunity for me because I'm just an emerging yoga student, and I thank you for that. So I've given my contact below. You can please feel free to reach out anytime you want. So let's start with the topic. So this is the overview of how I'm going to discuss my topic. So from the scope, we'll learn how yoga is a prospect as if you want to pursue it as a profession and why there is need of yoga in USA. So yoga and Ayurveda are allied health sciences, which are, you know, really cheap. They need minimum setup, but still you get a good compensation if you are rightly and correctly certified. So for the need of yoga, we are going to discuss how the health statistics of US is poor and how health expenditure in US is really high. So as a profession, we can see that it is beneficial to us because it doesn't need huge setup like gymnasiums, and it is minimalistic way to be physically and mentally stable. So secondly, we'll also go through why USA needs to implement yoga as one of their ways to improve the health of people in USA, because it has poor health statistics and they spend a lot of money on healthcare. USA is highly burdened because of its expenditure, and that is why they, you know, keep on doing researches, and it is increasing the healthcare cost unnecessarily. So let us move on to the next slide and learn why we can pursue it as a profession in USA and why it is a good option. So let us go through some details. when I was back in Kaviladham, I was taught yoga without any support, without blocks, without chairs, no apparatus at all. So we used yoga mat only and sometimes the wall of support. So I agree that support gives you a better experience, but doing it without support can help you build naturally. And that body that is built because of yoga is going to be original. It does take time, but you have to be patient. So if you were to start a yoga class in USA, it is affordable because you need no setup. And that is the major part of yoga. It becomes cheaper. And if you are a beginner, you can get up to $15 per hour, I think, which is a good start. An empty hall can work. A huge room, a huge space, which has nothing in it, can also work. So the two main factors of any therapy are accessible and it being affordable. So it has to be affordable to both to the service provider and the customer. So live online yoga classes is a great way to pursue yoga as a profession in USA. In the United States, you can see that this is well compensated in terms of salary because it is, you know, comparable to other health sectors, but all you need is certification and you cannot miss that part. nowadays, huge companies like Microsoft and, you know, Google, they have started offering yoga classes to their workers because IT people are really having tough time. And they already have postural issues at a young age. So we all know that yoga can be a, you know, like a weapon to target like one thing, I mean, two things in like one shot. So recently, I read an article that here in New England, there are about 900 schools which have started a yoga program. So they have started offering yoga to the students from the school itself. I have referred to that article and you can see it in the reference section below. Yoga for professionals is an emerging branch in USA because there's corporate yoga, yoga teachers in schools, yoga teachers for hospitals and dentists. So especially with dentists, you can see that they have this cervical issue because they keep on bending down for the entire time. So yoga for dentists is another thing that has come up. and you can always pursue yoga because It is an unending branch, basically. People are going to try being fit. They are going to minimize their costs on healthcare. They want to be at home and yet, be healthy. So yoga as a profession in USA is a great option. Now we will see some lifestyle disorders in USA. So chronic diseases in America. So out of 6 in 10 adults in US have some or the other chronic disease. 4 in 10 adults in the US have 2 or more chronic diseases like heart disease, cancer, chronic lung diseases, Alzheimer's, diabetes. And it is a leading cause of death and disability in US. So this is one of the biggest reasons that you need to catch if you want to pursue yoga as a profession, because it will help you mentally and physically. Coming to the need of yoga in USA, the first point is extreme weather conditions and closed or artificial environment that people usually stay in. We all know that there are 4 time zones. So in this map, we can see that there is extreme hot weather, extreme dry weather, extreme cold. So the weather being the weather extreme is one big factor that you need to catch. All the people in USA tend to stay in artificial environments. People on East Coast usually go for heaters, and wherever there is hot climate, they tend to stay in cold air conditioned rooms. So there is a high chance that we feel claustrophobic, we have those breathing issues, dryness of the respiratory tract, and many diseases emerge because of that. And nowadays there is an addition that is we all are masked up these days because of COVID. So we do feel breathless. So pranayama, which is one of the anga of yoga, is very important that helps you to keep up your respiratory tract. It not only improves the CO2 and O2 exchange, which we refer as lung filtration, and which is a big thing that pranayama offers. So I would recommend for people in cold weathers, they can go for Surya Bedi Pranayam, and for people in hot weathers, they can go for Sheetali Pranayam. So yoga can be, you know, done to this, it can be narrowed down so much that you can like you can individualize it and you can take the benefits. So the life in US is really sedentary. I have been here not for more time, but like for 2 years, but the life here is sedentary and everything is automized. And so you get really less opportunities where you can be physically active. So, and going out of the house is a big challenge because of weather conditions and busy schedules. So yoga can be a great way. Need of yoga in USA. The other point is dietary habits. People have usually, you know, consume high sugar, frozen foods and canned foods. So we all know that ahara, according to Ayurveda, says that anything extreme is bad. So extreme sweet, extreme salty, extreme spicy is not good for health. Here, people usually tend to eat sweet stuff and they consume drinks like coffee, tea, and they go for canned foods, which is because a cheaper option. And it is easy to make and it stays fresh longer. So, but it contains a lot of preservatives, and that is the drawback that we have to understand. Even on the road, you can see people carrying Starbucks coffee, Dunkin' Donuts coffee, which is like a takeaway. And even in the stores, you can see that there are like different varieties of snacks and crackers, and people eat those snacks and crackers, and you can see in the health statistics what is the output. So usually they don't have a trend to cook at home. They would go outside and eat in the restaurants, like huge pizzas and burgers. So one factor is maida that they eat, so which is called as a multi-purpose flour. They rarely cook at home. And so you can see in the statistics that they are highly prone to diseases like cardiovascular diseases, diabetes, obesity, which are lifestyle disorders. So a modification in lifestyle is going to help. Yoga is not only about being physically active, but it is something more than that. So yoga is basically a lifestyle, how you live your life, how disciplined you live your life. So food, exercise, breathing, all these things are included in it. So let us take a look over at cardiovascular diseases. So 1 in 3 deaths are caused because of CVD, and US spends about $214 billion for that. For diabetes, you can see that 10.5% of them suffer from diabetes, and 21.4% cases are undiagnosed. In obesity, about 1 in 5 children and more, and 1 in 3 are more than 1 in 3 adults struggle with obesity. People who tend to be obese in the childhood often, you know, turn to be obese and during their adulthood. So nearly 1 in 4 young adults are too heavy to serve in the military. People with obesity often have a tendency to develop other diseases like heart disease, type 2 diabetes, and some types of cancers as well. And US spends about $147 billion for their treatment, which is a huge expenditure. So to summarize the health statistics, I would say that it is really poor. Here, the government pays about 80% health expenses for an individual, up to 80%. So to reduce the monetary burden on this country and in return on the world economy, it is essential that people adopt healthy ways of living. This is applicable to US, but it is applicable to the whole of the world, I feel. In India, people go for home remedies like Ayurveda, something called as Ajicha Batwa, we say. So people prefer that. But here in US, they would go and approach the service or health service provider for every small thing. So I think that is another big reason that healthcare system is costly in US. So I think yoga can be a cheaper way and yet an excellent way to deal lifestyle disorders in US. The next factor is isolation and lack of interaction, social interaction. people usually like to don't like to be alone, but and even if they want to be with the people, there is no option. They have to be alone. So the relationships here are usually, I feel, very professional and formal, and they are kind of shallow. So isolation is one big issue. The US, I feel that US is so system dependent, and it has less flexible work style. So isolation is one of the big issues. And we all know that mental health affects emotional health, then it affects the psychological health and hence the social well-being from childhood to adulthood. So mental and physical health are equally important components for the overall health. And if you want to protect yourself from long-lasting lifestyle disorders, you have to be mentally healthy. Presence of chronic diseases like CVDs and heart disease can be one of the reasons to fall prey for this mental health. As the data says, one in five Americans suffer from some of the other mental illness. CDC has also proved that having feelings of loneliness can affect the mental health. So yoga can be a great portal for people to hop upon and socialize and meet frequently. In-person classes can help you interact with other people, and this can be a great option for overcoming the isolation part, which is a big factor in US. Another part is the stressful life. So here are multiple reasons on this graph that I've put up that why life in US is stressful. Apart from health reasons, there are personal reasons like hectic schedules. So I have many routine examples of how unspontaneous our life is. Everything has to be planned, otherwise it becomes difficult and chaotic. So weather and long distance travels are one of the big factors that you need to plan your day. So you can also see that there are long wait times for doctor's appointments. The timetables are set like a month before. People in such hectic schedules hardly get time for themselves. In such pressures, they tend to smoke, drink alcohol, or even drink caffeinated drinks all throughout the day, which usually contain high amount of sugar. So it is said that pranayama and yoga helps to reduce cigarette and alcohol cravings. So that is another way, another thing. US needs yoga because they want to overcome their issues like drug epidemic in US. Yoga for so there is one, sorry. So there is one more strong reason that yoga can be pursued here, because after COVID, the gyms and have shut down. Many of the restaurants have shut down, so everything has ended, and people are trying to opt for healthy lifestyle from home itself. So live online yoga classes can be a great way to deal this. As we discussed before, it is minimalistic and you don't need any special setup. People can join in from the Zoom links and they can enjoy. I have observed after COVID that people are aware about yoga here. They know, but they don't know the right way to pursue it. They have kept it really superficial, and it is yoga for them is asanas, and that's it. But we need to rebrand yoga and tell them what exactly yoga is and what the scope of yoga is. So now let us take a look at the challenges that we can face while pursuing yoga in US. So here you can see, like, we will describe, I'll describe it in two ways. So to teaching yoga and to learning yoga. So we have to learn the receiver's end as well while we pursue yoga. So we are going to learn about the challenges. And first challenge is the certification and qualification. We cannot teach yoga in the United States without being certified according to US standards. Whereas in India, you can just take yoga classes. Any housewife can take yoga classes, but I do not support that much. So you need to be RYT certified, that is Registered Yoga Teacher Certification course, which is offered by the Yoga Alliance. the minimum certification required is RYT 200, which is a 200 hour program. And then you can start teaching yoga. Actually, I suggest 200 hours course because it is minimum and it is basic and you need that. But there are also courses that are offered for 500 hours and 700 hours. You can take those later once you pursue the 200 hour course, and you need to do it from a good school because it really counts. If you do it from some Indian school, it will be great because Indian schools also offer this certification. The certificate is essential as because it will give you the recognition and it will recognize your degree in US. In the actual market, while teaching yoga, you need a lot of variety because you cannot keep people like telling people to do the same asanas all the time. And 200 hour course offers really less number of asanas and types of pranayama. Another factor important here is self-practice. If you keep on practicing yourself, you can preach it really well. So you have to do much more even after you earn a certificate. The next point is costly yoga spaces. Renting spaces in USA is a big task, especially in cities like New York and Boston. It is very costly, but there's a higher chance that you get good students here because it is because they're busy cities. So one thing you need to know that yoga class cannot be crowded. It has to be empty. You need plenty of space. It has to be aerated. It has to have fresh light. So you need a good hall or a good place for that. But such places are costly in US. Apart from that, there is this documentation. You need your social security number and all those legal things. So doing a job in a studio can be one way to overcome this challenge of costly spaces. But again, you need to have certification for that. Attracting and retaining students is one big challenge in US. You have to work at the best potential for marketing your class, but because of the high rates of the classes, people don't find it reasonable, or the timings can also not be flexible for them. So they don't opt for yoga. Fortunately, after COVID, you have the online option where you can teach simple asanas, because teaching complex asanas online can be a tough job from as professionals. Yoga does need rebranding in USA because they have kept it superficial, and explaining the mental benefits and the physical benefits can be a great way to attract the target. We do need more research on yoga from our part, I feel, and research in yoga can be other prospect for us. So the next point is preserving integrity. So many people have wrong perception about yoga. They look to it as a physical workout, but it is something more than that. It is the union with the cosmos, so I think, which is a big spiritual teaching. They have diluted yoga by saying hot yoga, by doing cold yoga, beer yoga, power yoga, and they have messed it up all. I think that is one reason people make fun of the science. So one challenge is to preserve the originality of that science before we preach it. So yoga for therapeutic benefits. Yoga therapy is something that draws on yoga exercises, practices, and philosophies to improve mental and physical health. While the practice of yoga is commonly associated with stress relief, yoga can be a great way to treat these mental conditions. In spite of yoga at its best effects, yoga, using it as a therapy is challenging because people won't go to a yoga therapist if they have some back pain or anything related to mental health. They will approach a doctor first. So yoga, even if we as professionals want to offer it for therapeutic benefits, it becomes a tough task. Now, let us see what challenges are there from the students' part. So absence of insurance coverage in USA is a big thing. One needs a health insurance in USA because health system is really costly. yoga is not recognized in USA and Indian degree is not at all recognized. So very few people are ready to pay out of pocket expense for therapies like yoga and Ayurveda. Like we have discussed before, people have diluted yoga. There are a lot of misconceptions about it. So we need good teachers. So finding good teachers is another challenge from the receiver's point of view. Another tough factor is consistency. Yoga needs to be done sincerely. It has to be, because it doesn't give immediate effects. You have to be patient. You have to keep doing it for a long time. But busy schedules and busy routines are part of US life. So yoga is all about discipline and consistency. Taking some time off for it also becomes difficult on the receiver's end. So we as professionals have to think about innovative ideas so that we can provide them with flexible schedules and they can opt for the science. The important point that I noticed is the language barrier. Majority of texts of yoga are written in Sanskrit, may it be Patanjali, may it be Bhagavad Gita. So to understand the basics, how much ever we try to translate, we cannot translate. Just like Harry Potter in Hindi is going to sound funny, translation for Atma, Man, Samadhi in English is going to sound funny. So language is another barrier that people face while learning yoga, and that is a reason that they do not take much interest. So we have to find ways that we can, tell them the exact meaning of what yoga is. So these are a few challenges that I noticed. So I want to share my experiences here while I was interning with National Alliance on Mental Illness. So it is a mental illness firm which is spread in about 48 states in US. So recently I designed a yoga program for them, which will be available on their website soon. So I noticed that they are trying to provide free yoga sessions, free meditation sessions to the people using a website. But I had knowledge of yoga and I designed the program in such a way that it can be, anyone can do it. But I think proper guidance is required for doing all these things. Any asana is not easy. You need to understand that, because there is this development till phase and you need to go from simple asanas to complex asanas. When I design a program online, it is very tough for me because I don't know the target audience. I don't know what students are in front of me. So I enjoyed that project, but it was a difficult task on my part. So I thought that recognition of yoga is very essential. And this has to be done from India. India has to recognize its own certifications, and then we can use it worldwide. Even though I am a certified yoga instructor, advanced instructor, my certificate is not valid here in the US. So I feel that India has to work on it and for making it recognized all over the world. Second thing is during interviews, I experienced that they do appreciate the talent that you know something about allied health sciences, Indian health sciences. So people from India who are trying to come here and trying to pursue allied health sciences really have a great opportunity. If they are rightly certified, they can do it. So to summarize, I would say that yoga is a minimalistic way to stay healthy and mentally and physically. So it is a cheaper way and everyone can opt for it. Yoga has no age barriers and anyone can start it at any point. Second thing is you need to take RYT certification, RYT 200 Yoga Alliance certification, which is minimum to match the US standards. And third is, while teaching yoga, we need to preserve the originality of that science before preaching it. So here are the references from which I took all this related to CDC and everything. And I have mentioned the article also. You can go through that article which in about the 940 schools where yoga program was started. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Shruti ji. You have made us aware about all the challenges and opportunities in USA. It's good to like hear that, and it would be beneficial for most of the students who are hearing or watching this session, so that related to their career, if they want to start, so it would be easy for them. And as per like, I was not aware about all these things, obviously, so it would be great to know. So now we can start the question answer round as well. Quickly in my mind, one question is coming. So how over there it's very expensive to start our own studio, or yes, you know, taking a rented hall or something like that. It's very expensive. So is it possible to start? I mean, are people
I cannot hear you.
They allow to start at their home like we are doing in India?
You can. You
is
can.
It,
all...
Is it audible now?
Now, yes, audible? Now it is audible.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, renting spaces becomes really costly in US. So you can start. You can take yoga classes at home, but I think it's not the right way. So if you have the certification, then you can do it at home. But if you want to attract students, it should be professional, right? So taking yoga classes at home is not professional. It doesn't look professional. So I think it's better you get affiliated to some studio before, then you learn how that administration part runs, because everything here is based on licenses and certification. So I think it's better you take a certification and then proceed.
Right. Okay. We can have a more question answer round. If anyone wants to share their own views or they want to ask something to Shruti ji, they are most welcome.
Yeah, I would also invite Bankim ji here, because Bankim ji is from Houston, Texas. Like, I don't know exactly. Houston, right? And for more than 3 decades in US with the community. So definitely, I think all these things, what Shruti ji was talking about, you have experienced it over the period of time. And definitely we would love to have even your inputs on how we as Indians, because we are celebrating 75 years of India's independence. And when we see the contribution of the freedom fighters, it was not very easy. Yeah, if they would have also said, like, fighting the British is difficult, the Britishers have the empire across the world, let's go back to our homes and have our ordinary lives. Mujhe khana banana hai, bachchon ko school jana hai. So we would have still been under imperialism, right? So somewhere, yes, there are challenges, and that's the reason why we are celebrating this event, where somewhere the like-minded people who are doing something good in the field of yoga, they come together, they do a synthesis, the manthan is taking place. I still remember Bankim ji saying, I love this program very much, but I don't feel that I can share it to my friends because they don't have the taste of this. And even as the best person, we feel so much of like, and then that's true. You can see right now, we have more than 300 yoga students in Swasti, and the attendance is what you can see in the screen. Yeah. And so if yoga teachers themselves find it so difficult to practice yoga, and that was Shruti ji highlighted, how can you make these things interesting? How can you keep students coming in? It's a very big challenge. Yeah. And it's, I think this is the right platform where we can discuss those challenges. And also we can see to it that some of the creative ideas, can we implement them also? Because many a times it happens in conferences that we have beautiful, beautiful solutions which are not applied anywhere in the world. And that's what the US healthcare is into crisis. They have so much of healthcare expenditure into research, which is not coming place on ground reality. So I think we can learn from them. And with the kind of little resources that we have, let's see what best we can do in our day-to-day lives, in our day-to-day practice. So over to you, Bankim ji. You can please do come in.
Namaste, Shruti ji. I'm glad that I have someone who is seeing the morning, right? sunrise.
Yeah, true.
No, but yeah, nice session. You, I would say you captured basically, you know, the cross section of US, right? I mean, the current setup and how, you know, the system works here. So yes, now what I, you know, again, I think my views may little differ, okay? See, first is that from being India, the first, what you call principle, which we have to embrace is that yoga, which we are offering, right? Basically, we can say our, you know, philosophy, even that is how Swami Vivekananda put it, right? He says, you know, the rest of the world can give us science and technology to an extent, but more than that, what we can offer them is, you know, this spirituality, and obviously yoga is a part, you know, our philosophy, okay? And yes, that is badly needed, okay? So first principle which you have to say is that no, yoga is not a profession, okay? Put it that way. It's not, we should not, I mean, what is, yes, put it that way, that it's a service, you know, which we have to offer. And I would say selfless service. That is number one principle, okay? Things, yes, rest of the things will fall in line, okay? You know, they will come, okay? All that will come in line because that is the first thing which is lacking. See, the first mindset people have is materialism. Even today, they connect everything, every aspect of life from the day they wake up in the morning till, you know, they sleep. It's all about materialism. Connecting, you know, the happiness and, you know, everything, you know, material aspects. So that is, so first is, you know, we have to offer is as a service. And second is, yes, you are right. The misconceptions are there, but the patience is required. And I, as you know, Gurudev mentioned that even, and I realize, you know, I always call it, you know, tribal few and, you know, tribal, you know, tribal many and vital few. Okay, right? So you have so much of information and so much is spreading, right? All this, you know, good, all this good initiatives, you know, and at Swasti Yoga is such a great initiative. Unless you talk to a person, right, you know, one-to-one, I think probably the message may not come across. And forwarding the messages, forwarding the information, that's not going to help. Because there is so much of it. People look at it and then say, oh, you know, even some people may find me crazy, you know, that, okay, oh, you know, you are spending so much time on this aspect. Okay. And I see that. Okay. I can sense that. So, but which is quite natural. But at the same time, I see that the change is happening. And if we are, you know, honest, if we are forthcoming, if we offer this as a service, then slowly and surely the people will embrace it. Because it's all about well-being, right? I mean, who does not want, you know, to be well, right? That is a fundamental. And we can see that. And I see those changes, you know, happening slowly. And even I, after let's say in our Houston area, you know, quite a few associations, you know, from India, I would name, you know, like, for example, Ramakrishna Mission, Arya Samaj, Brahma Kumaris, you know, I think there is one Swami Vivekananda, you know, some institute of yoga. So, you know, initiated. And in fact, after being in association with, you know, Swasti, I see that Swasti Yoga, I would say, I would not call it opportunity, but I would say, let me capture the right word, okay? It's not, I would say an obligation, put it that way. Why I say obligation is that you have the knowledge and the resources. And if that knowledge and resources is not spread for the good of the humanity, then it goes waste to an extent, okay? So I would definitely, yes, encourage, you know, Swasti Parivar to, you know, spread all across the world for the well-being, and especially, yes, country like US. And I would be glad to be, you know, glad to be a volunteer, you know, to do that. And I again, Shruti ji, you did great. And I'm glad that, you know, you are also connected with Swasti Parivar.
Yes, thank you.
Great. I feel like everybody should give a big round of applause to both Bankim ji and Shruti ji. Because it really takes a big amount of courage to be in a foreign land and to be firm on your roots. And though things are very hostile, you still you have to gather a lot of courage and present yourself because you are.
Audio. Yeah, there is.
Yeah, I think there was. Yeah, there is a network issue, I think. So, sir was saying.
Let's wait for a few seconds. I think it will come up.
Yeah, we will. Yeah. Sure, we'll wait.
Okay, yeah. Okay, got it. You have to repeat what you said last.
Yes. So, the thing is like, you are our commanders in US. So, we are just the army. So, we wish you best wishes and we would be following you anything that you need from our end. All the family members are there to be with you and provide whatever best we can do. But I loved what you said, Bankim. Mm. Whenever we start with our career and all these things, things should fall in line very immediately. And that's where even Shruti ji highlighted it's that's the problem with the Western mindset also. They are very commercial and everything is associated with instant output and in a tangible way. Avyakta and Amurta Nirgun is something which is yet to come in their in the dictionary. So we cannot expect them to understand. Okay. But still, as you said, we have to keep trying. And that's, I think we have to live our philosophy, Karma Yoga. We have to keep working. We have to keep giving it back, giving it to the people. And even if, like, the way we get inspired from nature, whether it's the sun, the trees, every day we do Surya Namaskar, every day we do Vrikshasan. And actually, they are trying to teach us whether a child hits the tree to get the fruit, or whether it is the farmer who has planted the tree is happily giving the fruit to both of them. So whether the community around you is cursing you or criticizing you for what we are doing, or whether some people are appreciating us, I think we have to be equally compassionate and loving to wherever we are. And I think this elements of nature give us this kind of inspiration. I hope, Shruti ji, you might have experienced some of the beautiful moments also. Would you like to share some of them? Like where you felt very much proud to be an Indian, where somebody was really overwhelmed to understand how deep yoga is or our philosophy is, or about Ayurveda.
Yeah, there are like two incidences that recently I experienced. First was my internship with NAMI, and when they asked me that I have to design a yoga program because they assumed that because I'm from India, I know what yoga and Ayurveda is. And of course, they saw it on my resume. But as an Indian, their first impression was, that means you know yoga and we need your help. So that was one moment where I really felt proud that having a yogic background was a plus for me. So I think that was one moment where I felt proud. And other was like a couple of days back during the interview, one of my HR, she said that she had visited India to Mysore, and then she learned Ayurveda and yoga. And that is the reason she could catch my resume. So that is another thing that where I felt proud of having from this background. And she insisted me that I should help them, I should suggest them some good things about yoga, and I should utilize my knowledge in their field. So which was like a very big compliment for me. So yeah, they are aware about what yoga is.
And one more thing I came to know from this conversation is, unless we have more and more people from the West or from the world coming to India and experiencing what India is, because you cannot sit in US and see the news and make a judgment about India, because most of the time, I think what the kind of news you get about India is completely different than the reality. So I think if we have more and more exchange, like more and more Indians go in the world and understand. So that's what I want to appeal, make an appeal to all our Swasti students. Like, yes, travel the world, because that is going to expand you, expand your mind, expand your thinking. That's very, very important. Your benchmarks, our benchmarks are, we know now, Shrutiji, like the way we have been many things in common. So many times it happens that we have our benchmarks, which are like, okay, in local, we are comfortable. We don't want to get out of our comfort zones. But I would encourage all our students to travel as much as possible, see what things are happening outside. That is very, very important. And second thing is, encourage many, many international students to come to your place, to visit different parts of India, so that it really helps in changing the policies and changing the outlook of the world towards India. I think that is something which would also be helping. Because next time, if you have your colleagues or your boss who has already been in India and has a positive thought about India, definitely then it might reflect in the way we are being treated and our communication takes ahead. So, great. Thank you very much. We have other students also. Any other questions? There are so many interesting things I feel like we can ask. And I'm very keen to know from Shrutiji and Bankimji, because sooner or later, we would like to see everyone in different parts of the world spreading the message of yoga, enjoying yoga. And as Shrutiji, what you are saying is, it's a dire need that we translate yoga. And translating yoga in English is not translation. We have to translate yoga in the terminologies of different sciences. We have to translate yogic terminology into engineering. We have to translate yogic terminology into business, yogic terminology into politics. And that is where yoga will be truly integrated. Otherwise, it will remain as a part of physical activity, as an exercise. If you really want to spread the idea, see, like, now this is live and I'm talking too much, but Bankimji, you might have got, and everybody might have got the point, that we all are from diverse fields. So let us try to integrate and translate yoga into our field, and try to rewrite Yoga Sutras, rewrite Hatha Yoga Pradipika from, for example, engineering point of view, artificial intelligence point of view, public health point of view. And that would be a real integration of the philosophy of yoga, making it more strong. I think Pooja ji has raised the hands.
Yeah. Please. Yeah, this thought of taking yoga to different fields and speaking in that language, it's so much easier for people to understand what we really mean. Like, I feel definition in Sanskrit, what we speak, and the words which English language has, Sanskrit will have so many meanings to one feeling. And so many words to one feeling. And at every level of feeling, there is a different word for that feeling. But like love, we have prem, sneha. We can show it in express it in different thoughts. But in English, it is just one word. It could be compassion. But then again, there are so many words. So if we can reach out to different fields and explain in their language, I think reaching out is going to be far more easier. And like you said, writing our own new Yoga Sutras now, the way world is going, and we are all union, all of us are one. So if we can speak each other's language, it's going to be easy to connect and understand yoga. Amazing. This was a new thought. Thank you.
Yeah, that's correct, actually.
Our sir is Shrutiji. Our sir are there, Dr. Prabhuji. So it's a great honor to have him here. So if he is there, I would request him to bless us all.
I think he's in the clinic. I don't know. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm in the clinic. I am in my clinic.
Yes. Great, sir, to have your darshan. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. You talked so many things regarding Shruti and her yoga. This is nice yoga, we can say.
Absolutely. New aspect. Yoga zala
plus. Yoga zala.
Yoga yoga.
Right. Great.
Very nice. Actually, it should be in USA, not only USA, but all over world. They can go through yoga and Ayurveda also, as Shruti was saying, because it is both are a different type of thinking materials in that, and they are most. You have, unless you can understand the thinking of that particular verb, it becomes very difficult to get it in the mind or heart. That what I want to say. You talk very nicely regarding Shruti. I am very thankful to you.
Thank you
very
much.
Thank you, Baba.
Yes. खूपच छान म्हणजे आज खूपच वेगळं वाटतंय छान
वेगळं अगदी म्हणजे काय प्रश्नच नाही कारण ती योगाच्या संदर्भात काम खूप करत होती पण गेले 5-7 दिवस जे काही ते काय अभ्यास करत होती त्याच्यातनं ती कोणता अँगल शोधून काढेल हे नव्हतं कळत हे आता ऐकल्यावर लक्षात आलं की तिने वेगळ्याच अँगलनी त्याच्यात हे केलेलं आहे आणि खूपच चांगलं केलं हे काही ठिकाणी बारीक चिमटे पण होते पण सूचना पण होते
No, wonderful. Shruti, we are very much proud of you. Mm-hmm. And absolutely, the challenges that you pointed out are challenges for all of us. And we will see to it that how we all together can take these challenges head on. Okay. So definitely this 75 years of independence is just the reason. I mean, this is a very good reason how we can chalk out the plans, future plans of the new India, which will initiate or take the lead the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Shruti. It was wonderful.
Thank you.
Yeah. I will just continue with the presentation part so that we have a small small activity. And before that, we will, everyone, please give a big round of applause to Shruti ji.
Thank you.
We cannot come to Boston, but this is how virtually we would love to pay our respect. And this is a virtual felicitation.
Thank you. Hope. I appreciate it.
Thank you very much for being a part of the family. And now we have the second part. We had one more activity in this celebration of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. And that is, we wanted to have a yoga calendar for our 2022 Swasti Yoga calendar. And we have invited all our students from almost 35 countries. We have students. So from the idea of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, we wanted to have a New Year calendar which binds all the people across the world together with a yogic caption and the yoga practices that they do with the iconic landmarks of their country.
Wow.
So we have the calendar 2022. This is our student from Philippines, and the caption that she has given is, "Nature is the purest portal to inner peace." And yes, we can enjoy the calendar. In the month of January, we have the caption given by Anjali ji is, okay, the postpartum yoga she is practicing with the cutest little yogi, and the photo is so beautiful. And you can see the gaze, the child, the baby is just looking and observing. Next, Ashish ji. So yoga is the stilling of, yoga is the stilling of the changing states of the mind. Next, Shetambari is saying is yoga is a flame. When you light it up, the glow never fades away. Wow. March and April, we have Deepak Kumarji from Malaysia doing the Shirshasana. Willingness is the first step towards achievement. In the month of May, we have Rahul Singhji. You might have seen him even yesterday in the calendar shoot. So wonderful and beautiful, elegant asana practice that he is working on. Ekam Sat Vipra Bahuda Vadanti, the verse from Rugved, which talks about, yes, the idea of yoga is one. We all perceive it in different ways, but this unity and diversity is very, very important. Rather than we colliding with each other, we uniting and our strengths is very important. That's the message from Rugved. We have Hyacinth. It was her photo from Philippines. We have Swati More, who is saying, every downfall makes you strong. Collect yourself and fly higher. Wonderful. In August, we have Rashmi Arora, who is saying, even a happy life cannot be without a measure of darkness. And the word happy would lose its meaning if it were not balanced by sadness. It is far better to take things as they come along with patience and equanimity. Wonderful. And it's so interesting to see that these places are in Pune. Okay. I've never seen this place. It's in Wagholi. I don't know where is it. But yeah, that's how creative and beautiful our students are. So Sagarika Ji from Malaysia, she is professionally into modeling and other activities. Silence is the gateway to your inner soul. Lionel, he again defies this statement that age is, he says that age is just a number. So at his age, he is into skiing. So in the Alps, he has posted his photo from France. We have Madhura Ji, very beautiful. Swabhasha, Swadesha, Swadharmastave, Je Swabhagye, Ithe Jalmale, Maniti Je, Asa Janma Hetu, Jayancha Urat, Ashanchi Shivaji, Ase Janma Jat. So she has taken this beautiful photo from Rajgarh. Again, this is these aspects about our forts, about our culture, Shivaji Maharaj. I think we have not been able to present it in front of the world. So it's very important that the world, people across the world come here, they experience these aspects, because even this, I feel, as yoga tourism, everybody is getting into Goa and Rishikesh. I think there are many other places. I mean, Maharashtra is very much neglected as far as these aspects are concerned. So Shruti ji, just talk about hiking or aplya gad killyan baddal zara bola tikde Bankim ji, you also can because we have this again the slogan given by our prime minister, vocal for local. Will talk for our own folks? We have to talk, because when we go to Europe and other places, yeah, even a small stone is preserved in such a way as if it is more precious than gold. And here, even such beautiful artifacts are lying on the street. Nobody is caring, and we are like very much not interested. So I think with this celebration of our independence, we can just talk about our own things and be proud of it. Even if nobody cares, we have to just keep loving ourselves and believing in our culture. So this is how our calendar shoot, extremely beautiful. You can see how the sunset, beautiful sunset. Whenever I see these photos, I don't feel like at any way, the Indian or our nature, so much we are blessed. Like if you go to some of the countries, you only have deserts, you only have snow. But India is a place where you have every aspect blessed with nature. So that's beautiful. Sanya Ji is saying the only way out is within. Now in context to what we talk about, that people in US are into isolation. Yes, yoga also talks about isolation, but it is a very spiritual isolation, which would be a different approach that we can give. And as you said, you need the right teacher who can make you experience what this going within is all about.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Mm-hmm. That was today's program. Over to Hina Ji and Shruti Ji.
Thank you so much, sir. good to see the calendar of 2022 and beautiful photographs everyone has given and quotes which will inspire every day when we see the calendar. So I would request everyone to please contact Swasti Yoga Center for this calendar. It would be great to have this type of things in at our home, being a yogis, you know. So will inspire us every day. These postures or these quotations, we can say, they will inspire us every day when we see this calendar. Okay, so, sorry. Let's quickly going towards our next weekend sessions. Next week on 1st of January, which is on Saturday, we have a session by our student Jyoti Mahadikar. And the topic would be simple meditation practices for beginners. And next day on 2nd of January, we have a guest lecture by Dr. Manmat Gharote sir. He's a yoga guru at Lonavala. And the topic would be importance of ancient wisdom to understand the real message of yoga. So I would request everyone to please don't try to miss this session, these two sessions, which these are very, very, very informative. It would be, and definitely we are going to learn so many things from these sessions. Also, we are live on Facebook and Instagram. Check these videos on YouTube. Our previous videos are also uploaded on YouTube, so you can check all these things. And please try to share these links and our YouTube links to everyone, or this session Zoom link to everyone, to your near ones, so that they will also get benefited from this ancient knowledge. And I would request everyone we will to sit straight for the closing prayer. First, we are going to chant Omkar. Keep your hands in Dhyan Mudra on your knees. Keep inhaling, start chanting Om. Slowly join your palms for Shanti Mantra. Inhale. Om Sahana Bhavatu Sahana Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karvavahai Tejasvinavadhitamastu Ma vidvishārvahai. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Shanti, Shanti.
Gently rub your palms. Place your warm palms on your eyes. Absorb the energy. Slowly open your eyes from darkness to lightness. Thank you so much, everyone. Namaskar.
Thank you.
A special thanks to Hina ji for, in spite of all the challenges, all the difficulties, you still are the backbone for all our programs and Swasti.
Thank you,
everyone. Thank you, Shruti ji.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. You are blessed. Thank you, Bankim ji.
Thank you.
Thank you.